joy of showing you the trailer and the songs is immense. And I know that the Telugu audience love melodies, they love music. They've been supporting me for 27, 28 years. I've been in Telugu industry from 84, playing from Ramesh Naidu garu to Raj Koti garu to Chakravarti garu. And so that set my whole pattern of film music. And Koti garu's come. Thank you. Thanks for coming. And legends like K. Vishwanath garu, Raghavendra garu, and Balachandra sir, Mani Ratnam. We've learned so much from them. So this musical is actually a dedication to all these great directors who done great service to music, brought music and movies to the people like us. And that's the inspiration which led me to write the story, so that we can, in my life I've experienced many different things and gone to many different countries, experienced great music and everything. So my idea was to bring those experiences and sensibilities to the screen, to our own people. And that's one of the reasons I took a young director who had the passion to create my vision, make my vision into a reality. And I want to thank Gio, Ideal, all of them for supporting me. And the great cast, Manisha Koirala, Lisa Ray, Ranjit Barot, Rahul Ram, of course our Ihan Bhatt, whom we had discovered, and who's very promising. All the girls like him already. And Edil C. There's a big list. And thanks Kiran Garu for helping us get this, like, not like a, it is like a real movie. People love the Telugu version the most. And that's something everybody who watches, I like the Telugu version the most. That's what I keep saying. And Rakendra Mouli Garu. And Sitarama Sastri Garu couldn't come because he's taken the vaccine. So I hope that all of you are safe and healthy, and thanks for coming in this COVID season. I really appreciate your kindness. Telugu, Chiranjeevi song.
I have never visited Hyderabad, but it was like a dream to come to this city. And whatever I saw on the way, the glimpses of Hyderabad is as beautiful as I imagined. Thank you everyone for coming here today. Thank you.
ఈ రోజు నిజంగా నేను వస్తుండగానే సాంగ్ ఆల్రెడీ ఓపెన్ అయిపోయింది. దహమాన్ బ్రాండ్ మట్టుకి ప్రతి పాటలోనూ ప్రతి సంగీత ప్రియుల హృదయాలకి శాశ్వతంగా అలా ఉండిపోయే విధంగా ఉంటుంది ప్రతి పాట. అంటే అంత డెడికేటెడ్గా వారు ప్రతి పాటని కంపోజ్ చేస్తారు, రాత్రింబవళ్ళు కూర్చొని పనిచేస్తూనే ఉంటారు ఆయన. ఆ టైమింగ్స్ అసలు అంతే ఉండదు. సో ఈరోజు నన్ను పర్టికులర్గా నిన్న ఆయన రావటం నాకు ఫోన్ చేసి మీరు తప్పకుండా రావాలి అని, ఆ చిన్ననాటి స్నేహితుడు మాకు ఒక అన్నదమ్ముల్లాగా, నేను ఎంతో బిజీ మ్యూజిక్, నేను రాజ్ కోటిగా ఉన్నప్పుడు రెహమాన్ మా చిన్న వయసులో మాతో జాయిన్ అయ్యి, సో వండర్ఫుల్ మ్యూజిషియన్ ఆయన. ఎన్నో పాటలకి మాకు ఏం కావాలో ఇచ్చేవాడు. అంటే చాలు నేను అంటే లేదు, నేను ఇంకా ఇస్తానని అన్ని రకాలుగా మాకు అటువంటి టోన్స్ ఇచ్చేవాడు. నేను అసలు రికార్డింగ్ చేసే రోజు లేదు, అలాగే ఓన్లీ 3 ట్రాక్ రికార్డింగ్. ఇప్పుడు మల్టీ ట్రాక్స్ డిజిటల్ అంతా వచ్చేసింది, డాల్బీ డిజిటల్ అని. అప్పట్లో 3 ట్రాక్ రికార్డింగ్లో తాను ఇచ్చిన టోన్స్ మటుకు అమేజింగ్. ఇప్పటికీ ఆ పాటలు ఎప్పటికీ ఈ బిట్ రెహమాన్ గారు వాయించారని మేము గొప్పగా చెప్పుకుంటుంటాం అనమాట ప్రతి పాట అనమాట. ఒక గోపా గోరింక కానీ, వానచల్లు కానీ,
ట్రైలర్
పక్కలు జస్ట్ వన్స్ మోర్ పోడింగ్ లేటర్. అలాగా రెహమాన్ గారు వాళ్ళ అమ్మగారు కూడా మొన్న రీసెంట్గా అదే ఏర్పాటు. ఎంత ఇంటిమసీ అంటే ఒక ఫ్యామిలీ, మేమంతా ఒక ఫ్యామిలీలా ఉండేవాళ్ళం చెన్నైలో. ఆ అభిమానంతో ఇప్పటికీ తను నా రెహమాన్ ఎప్పుడు అలాగే ఉన్నాడు, కానీ ఏ మార్పు లేదు. ఆస్కార్ అవార్డు వచ్చినా కూడా నా రెహమాన్ ఎప్పుడు అలాగే ఉంటాడు అది మాకు తెలుసు. సో సో హ్యాపీ రెహమాన్ యూ ఇన్వైటెడ్ మీ టుడే. నేను కూడా తను చూడడం చాలా రోజులుగా, మొన్న చెన్నైకి వెళ్దాం అంటే కూడా కుదరలేదు బికాస్ ఆఫ్ కోవిడ్, దీనివల్ల వెళ్ళలేకపోయాను. చాలా సంతోషం. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
ద రీజన్ వై ఐ థింక్ టు గో ఫ్రమ్ అ కంపోజర్ టు రైటర్ టు ఫిల్మ్ మేకర్ ఇస్ ఎన్ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ ప్రాసెస్. సో బికాస్ యూఆర్ ఆల్సో కంపోజర్ అండ్ వీ వర్క్ టుగెదర్ ఐ వాంటెడ్ యూ టు సీ ద హోల్ ప్రోగ్రెస్ ఆఫ్ వాట్స్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ ఇన్ ద ట్రైలర్. సో యు కెన్ వాచ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ దట్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
నేను తమిళ్లో అక్కడ నాళయ్య కునర్ అని చెప్పి షార్ట్ ఫిలిమ్స్ కాంటెస్ట్లో ఒక షార్ట్ ఫిలిమ్స్ చేసి కొన్ని అవార్డ్స్ అవి పొందాను. అవి చూసి రెహమాన్ గారు ఈ సినిమా పోస్ట్ ప్రొడక్షన్కి తెలుగు తమిళ్కి నన్ను ఇన్వాల్వ్ చేశారు. అట్లా ఆ ప్రాసెస్లో ఆయనతో వర్క్ చేసి ఒక ఆ పాటలు విని విని తెలుగులో ఎవరైనా ఒక కొత్త లిరిసిస్ట్ని పట్టుకో అన్నారు. నేను చెప్పాను నేనే చేస్తానండి అన్నాను. నువ్వు చేస్తావా అన్నారు. నేను చేస్తానండి అన్నాను. ఏంటి నీకు ధైర్యం అన్నారు. మీరే సార్ అన్నాను. సరిగ్గా రాయి లేకపోతే చంపేస్తాను అన్నారు. ఆ భయంతో ప్రాణాల దగ్గర పెట్టుకోవాలని చాలా భయభక్తులతో రాసిన ఒక పాట ఆకాశ తారలతో. ఇంకొకటి ఒక సిచ్యువేషనల్ సాంగ్, సీమంతం సాంగ్, పువ్వా మళ్ళీ పూసేవా అని ఈ రెండు సాంగ్స్ నేను రాశానండి.
తెలుగులో ఆయన అప్పుడప్పుడు ముద్దుగా ఏకైక మాట అది. సో జస్ట్ ట్రిపింగ్ ఆన్ యా మ్యాక్సిమం నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ సాంగ్స్ అని ఇట్ డెంట్ స్టార్ట్ లైక్ దట్ అండి. యాక్చువల్గా వెళ్ళినప్పుడు ఫస్ట్ ఒక పాట ఇచ్చారు. నేను అలా రూమ్లోకి వెళ్ళి ఇలా తీసుకొచ్చి సార్ పాట అయిపోయిందని చెప్పాను. అంటే అప్పుడే అయిపోయింది అన్నారు. అయిపోయింది సార్ అన్నారు. మళ్ళీ ఇంకో పాట ఇవ్వండి అన్నారు. ఇంకో పాట ఇచ్చారు. సో మళ్ళీ వెళ్ళాను రాసుకొచ్చాను. అది రెండు అయిపోయినా రెండు ఇంకో రెండు పాటలు ఉన్నాయి. సో ఒకటి రెండు అయింది, రెండు నాలుగు అయింది, నాలుగు ఎనిమిది అయింది. సో అట్లా
ఐ హావ్ టు టెల్ దట్ మడిరన్ గారు
నవాబ్ ఇన్ తెలుగు
నవాబ్ యా. సో నవాబ్లో వెరీ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్ సాంగ్. తమిళ్ ఎప్పుడు పడడం తెరల. వి డోంట్ నో హౌ టు డూ ఇట్ ఇన్ తమిళ్. సో ఐ సెడ్ ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ గెటింగ్ కాట్ దేర్ లెట్స్ ట్రై తెలుగు. సో వీ కాల్డ్ రాకేంద్ర మౌళి అండ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ వెరీ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్ సాంగ్ అండ్ హీ జస్ట్ క్రాక్డ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ వన్ అవర్ అండ్ షోడ్ మీ సంథింగ్ ఐ ప్లేడ్ టు మనీ సార్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ లైక్ ఓ మై గాడ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఫ్యాంటాస్టిక్ బికాస్ ఇట్స్ కెన్ యు టెల్ బాగా బాగా సాంగ్. సో దెన్ వీ బికేమ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ అండ్ ఐ థాట్ హీ వుడ్ మేక్ దిస్ హోల్ మ్యూజిక్ సౌండ్ ట్రాక్ అమేజింగ్ అండ్ దెన్ హిస్ థాట్స్ ఆర్ గ్రేట్ అండ్ వీ షేర్ సేమ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఫిలాసఫీస్.
పెదరాన్ గారు సో ఇందులో ఒక పాట రాశారు, శ్రీ షిరిడి సాయి అనే సాంగ్. సో ఆయన ఇక్కడ రాలేకపోయారు కానీ బట్ టు షేర్ స్క్రీన్ నేమ్ విత్ సచ్ లెజెండరీ పర్సన్ ఇస్ అన్ ఆనర్ అండ్ అదర్ లెవెల్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్స్పిరేషన్ ఇన్ మై లైఫ్. ఐ థింక్ లెట్ బి హిట్ ఆఫ్ లవ్ ఐ డోంట్ నో అబౌట్ ది కాన్సిక్వెన్సెస్ ఆఫ్ ద రిజల్ట్ బట్ దట్ గేవ్ మీ అనదర్ పర్స్పెక్టివ్ టువర్డ్స్ ది లైఫ్. సో ఎస్ వీ క్యాన్ డ్రీమ్, వీ క్యాన్ బి డ్రీమర్స్ అండ్ వీ కెన్ డ్రీమ్ ది ఇన్సానిటీ ద క్రేజీనెస్ ఆల్సో. సో ఐ థింక్ ఇట్స్ గుడ్ టు డ్రీమ్ ఇన్ సచ్ వే అబౌట్ ది వరల్డ్ పీస్. సో ద కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ దాట్ ఈస్ దాట్ సో వరల్డ్ పీస్ అనే స్పేస్లో ఒక పాట ఉంటుంది. సో ఐ హోప్ మీ అందరికి నచ్చుతుందని అనుకుంటున్నాను. అది నేను రాసిన దానికి నా అదృష్టంగా భావిస్తున్నాను. దట్స్ ద హోల్ పాయింట్. ఆల్సో
వెరీ హ్యాపీ టు బి పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్రాజెక్ట్. రమన్ సార్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్ అన్నారు. ఐ హోప్ వి కమ్ అవుట్ విత్ ఫ్లయింగ్ కలర్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఎగ్జామ్. అండ్ ఇంకా మాటలు అంటే ఇంకా స్క్రీన్ మీద చూడాలండి.
I think in 2001, when I went for Bombay Dreams to London, Andrew Lloyd Webber garu, okay, musical produced called Bombay Dreams, and he said, AR, do you have any story? He said. And I said, I'm just a composer. Why should I write a story? Why is this man asking me? And then I was thinking, because story and life and music is all connected. We see stories in everything. We see stories in music. You see, in poetry, in people, in experiences, and so this changed my whole look. That one question which he asked changed my look. And then after the Oscars, I became a member of the Academy, and I went for all these workshops for screenwriting and you know, filmmaking, camera. My house is very near to all these places, and so this 4-5 years had been a whole change in my the way I was thinking about cinema. So writing stories and meeting all the world class people like Spielberg and J.J. Abrams and so some of my friends said, like, I was telling some short stories to them. I said, this is fantastic, you should do a thing and so on. So then I started finding a director. Then we saw 750 auditions and found him in one of that. Then so because he needed to learn music in this as a character, so he can play the piano now. He's learned one year he was trained in a conservatory. And so this whole journey of understanding a completely new art, which is making me look at music in a very different way now. I was looking at music as a composer before, now I'm looking at as a filmmaker or as a storyteller, and also artistically going much more deeper into things rather than your surface level hit songs or, you know, that kind of thing. So this is the inspiration. Being a producer is very, it's like a gamble. We've seen many people take movies and sink and get lost completely. So I was very careful about that. Even if you're very careful, I think filmmaking experience actually scares you. You could lose everything you have if you're not sincere, I think. So in this, we've tried our best to, sometimes we had to take help from people, show the movie, and we finally got a cut which we're very happy with. I think I hope people also like it. And all three versions were refined and refined and refined and refined for almost 1.5 years, so that every lip sync is correct and every dialogue has feel in it. Every voice seems correct. Even the soundtrack, we finished mixing only day before us today. Because the Telugu sounded so good, as a language, Telugu is such a beautiful language, that we wanted the voice to be up. So I was shooting a live show for this, went back and remixed all the songs so that it all came up. So my director and both of us were searching, then there's Mukesh Chabraji, who, one of the top casting directors. So he was sending auditions after auditions. Like there was two hardest full of almost 700-800 boys out trying to audition for this. We were looking at everything, and then so one day he came in and said, there's one boy in Pakistan who's very close to what he plays guitar and he sings. I said, can't you find somebody in India here? You got 750, definitely there's one person in India. With that time, the Pakistani singers were coming and doing all this stuff. I said, something told me that I don't want my movie to be stopped. Something told me instinct, like, and this was like 5-6 years back. So I went back, I said, let's go, let's look at everything again. And I was very disappointed, because why is there one person who can't be this musician and with this character, Jay, in this? So went back and 1, 2, 3, 4, goes on, 10, 20, almost tired, and suddenly I saw his face. I said, who's this guy? He was like, no sir, his inexperience has come from Kashmir and all. Wait, that's what we are for. You know, we are, as a young company, we will do the nursery, we'll give the industry something. And we called him and said, yes, you are in. And what is your question?
Would I get paid for A.R. Rahman's film?
No, not that. You were not that greedy that time. You said, is this it? My life has opened up. I got my chance. It's all up to me now. Or something like that, I heard.
I am a big fan of Sir, you know, ever since I was a boy, you know, listening to his songs on cassettes, then CDs, then, you know, MP3s, and now streaming. So all my life, I've been a huge fan of Sir. You know, his music is aesthetically very pleasing and very different from what we hear, you know. And when I got the call for the audition for A.R. Rahman's film, I could barely hold the excitement, and I went to the audition. I don't know what I did there because I was so excited. And months later on, I got the call that I'm selected for the film. And I couldn't believe it. I mean, I couldn't contain my emotion when he told me, you're doing the film. I was like, what do you mean I'm doing the film? He's like, you're doing the film, you're the lead. I was like, I cried, I hugged him. I called my parents. It was like finally my dream came true. And after that, I met Rahman sir. Honestly, he's my role model. One of the best humans I have ever met in my life. You know, it would have been a producer-actor relationship, but with him, it's beyond that. You know, he cares about me, he guides me. Every time I meet him, it's about how to go ahead in life, how to be an inspiration, how to inspire people, how to be a good human being. That's all I've learned from him. and the best thing I love about him is, like, if you're a king of any country or you're a janitor on the street, he talks to everyone in the same way, you know. And it was Rahman sir's idea to send me to his music conservatory, which is in Chennai, KMMC. So I learned piano for a period of 1 year because he wanted that authenticity of the character to be there, because when I play, it shouldn't look or sound fake. So
Ihan's the other character, Ihan's friend Tenzin, you can talk about Tenzin.
Yeah, so Tenzin is my best friend in the film. I think he's my best friend in real life now also, because we lived together for 1 year and I used to call him Polo, he used to call me Jay, and there you go, method acting. So he was practicing drums and I was practicing piano for a period of 1 year. It was beautiful. I mean, in Chennai, I never felt like I'm away from home, because the way Rahman sir treated me, his family treated me, gifts and gifts every month, you know, meetings with Rahman sir. I mean, he doesn't have a brother, but if he had a brother, he would, I swear, treat him the same way like how he treated me all these years.
The movie has, what I really feel proud about this movie is to make the Northeast very inclusive. There's Tenzin who plays the Northeast, and we all treat Northeastern people different, unfortunately. They're all parts of India for me. And there's so much of music in Northeast. Now, I've been to Nagaland, I've been to Shillong, I've been to Sikkim, and there's so much of love, and I think we brought that essence in the middle of the movie, which we're really proud of. Religion, caste of the person singing, we enjoy the music. Not only in this country, but all over the world. And we listen to other people's music here. So, which is very true. I think it's inspired by real life, not my life, but what I see in the life of a musician. It's that in a musician life, or family, like if you take a family, and if any parent says, what does the son do, or what does the daughter do? And if they say he's a musician, they ask a question, what job does he take? What does he do? Is he working in office? No, he's a musician. No, music is fine, but does he do a job? Is he a doctor? So this social thing has been there for like decades, not only in India, but all over the world. The credibility as a musician or having the profession that credibility is still not there. And I feel like we try to tackle many different layers in this movie. And yet making it very entertaining, as you can see the trailer is. I think this is just an extension. Because after a point, movies are 27 years I've been doing music. And the formula of what people come to ask me songs are same thing. Give me 5 songs, 1 disco song, 1 romantic song, 1 sad song. And I was thinking, like, if we write our own script, then I'm getting inspired by K. Vishwanath Garu, which is the biggest inspiration for me. And what is achieved in screenplay with music. So that actually led us to one of the great inspirations, in Maniratnam Garu and Shankar Garu and all that stuff. So I was thinking that there should be music stories coming out and explaining the social status of where a musician is and the internal struggle which they go through. Where the song placements are coming, or even when people are now telling me scripts, so I'm getting ideas like, can we have a song here? Or can we have this much earlier or later? Can we have this as a heavy song? Can we have this meaning? So my mind has opened up so much. Because before it was just a composer.
Yes.
And somebody would write, and I'll just like, okay, give me the lyrics. And now there's, even in the words, even in the whole production of the song, everything has changed.
Could you place these songs of your choice in right places, unlike others' choice?
That means
because you are the writer.
Yeah, exactly.
Did you properly place the songs in this?
It was.
Could you bring that transformation in yourself or into your music?
Yes, it was very difficult because some of the songs I've taken, like, let's cross this mountain, you know, in the script. And when you go to the mountain, it's a mountain. For instance, there is a situation where the as a musician, he's growing from a simple writer to a complex writer, and then goes back to simplicity. So in that growth, he's trying to write something like Bach. Bach writes, you know, fugue is one of the greatest composers, and he writes fugue. So I was thinking, why don't we write? Because when somebody is learning, they always want to do something which is a bit difficult and to conquer that, like fugue writing or jazz. So we have all those styles which it goes into. If you listen to the soundtrack,
this film launch in like multi languages, you know, and since I don't speak a Telugu language, and now it's like releasing in Telugu, I am so thrilled and excited.
Better learn Telugu.
Yeah, exactly.
Next year. So now I'm
learning. Yeah, now I have a debut in Telugu. I'm gonna go home and start practicing Telugu. You know, because if you guys really like me, I would love to be an actor here also.
Actually, most of the movies get like Gautam Menon Garu always takes another version. No, E Maya Chesavu, and you know, you've seen that. Yeah, it's all Telugu versions are there. So I'm doing it. Nachindavuku music Telugu lo
anta bagundi sir andaru mee music vere languages lo unna sare memu download cheskoni vintam sir anta mee music ki fans ga mee Telugu lo kuda mee straight film expect chestunnam sir
adaltha I think that's one of the reasons we always dub our stuff with Telugu and also do straight like Gautam Menon Garu does a complete different version of that. Singers casting is also like, you know, how you cast a movie, because it's much more easy to listen to a song than watch a movie. You know, you can go in the car, you can still listen to it. And in this, most of the singers, I mean, almost all of the singers actually very, very gifted. Especially this guy, Sartha Kalyani, Vijay S. Das, they're all underused. Sartha Kalyani, if you discover in a show called Arrived, which is a QK show, and then Purvi Kotish, she is. Like, you might have Chandra Lekha long back, Anupama Jisan. She's got that kind of a talent now for this generation. Then Bela Shinde, we never hear her voice. So I heard 25 voices for the Shridhi Sai song. And I felt like her voice was very pure for the song. So we go through all this tedious process.
Hi, this is Trisha. I'm Radhika Apte.
Vasan Krishnamurthy.
Nenu Ali Matladutunnanu.
You're watching E3 Media Network.
E3 Media Network.
E3 Media Network.
E3 Media Network. E3 means
entertainment.
Entertainment. Entertainment.